Blessed is our God, who is now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
O Lord, hear my prayer, hear to my supplication, and hear to hear me your righteousness. Grant me the judgment of your services, O Lord, Saint, and the goodness of justice. For the enemy has persecuted my soul, especially my life and the ground, and made me dwell in the wrath of darkness, that those who have long been dead, and my spirit is overwhelmed, and my heart is in need of his distress. I remember the days of old, and meditate all your works, the cause of the works of your hand. I spread out my hand, and my soul falls to you, my flesh, and man, the life of course of your hand. Hear me complain, O Lord, my spirit prevails. Do not turn your face away from me, lest I be like those who put out of the pit. Cause me to hear your mercy in the morning, for you have a place of trust. Cease me to know, O Lord, the way of the flesh of all. I lift up my soul. Rescue me, Lord, from my enemies, to you that I have left you for refuge. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God, and your spirit is my strength, and I am of all purpose. Your name, for your name's sake, O Lord, you shall put me in your righteousness, you shall bring my soul out of trouble. And in your mercy, you shall utterly destroy my enemies, and you shall destroy all those who protect my soul, for I am sure.
God is the Lord, and has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Thanks to the Lord, and God, and his holy name.
God is the Lord and has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Searching for salvation, I have hastened unto you.
shelter I have with you in my life. You, the Theotokos and Virgin, violent me tortured for you are the cause of that which is good. Support of the faithful, the only all-praised one.
Yours, Father, Lord.
Faith of the great Greek theologian, Andrew Chrysostom, Anastasia Cicero, the merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas Bishop of Beer, and the Spirit of Bishop Benedictus. The wonder workers of the Holy Great Martyrs, towards victorious and teachers, the merciful of the theater, the recruit, the earthly commander, the Holy Higher Martyrs, the Apostles and Nathanius, the Holy Glorious Triumph of Martyrs, the Rebel God, the Set Father, of the Holy Righteous Ancestors of God, the Church of Ananda, and of St. Methodius, the Martyr Bishop of Olympus, Alistus, the first patron of Constantinople, Nicholas Cavasilas, whose memory we commemorate today, and of all the saints, we beseech you, O merciful Lord, hear our sinners, we pray to you, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Say. destino salitos, patrius in sedis eotropo, in aeri mandaris conte para conditos, cieli terras in terurimus, ici figlio terras in terurimus, che non so terra, in Christus non terra, in aria coros eolomo tribus san, in nostros eotropos, sere la libomber,
I'm
Saint, the servants of God, all pious and Orthodox Christians, those who reside within this community, the members, council members, contributors, and benefactors of this holy church.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Pray for the servants of God, whose names have been commemorated throughout this pedagogy service. Those that we pray for the call to mind at this time, those who are present who await your great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Safekeeping of this holy church and city and of all cities and towns, from pestilence, famine, earthquake, flood, fire, and sword, invasion of enemies, civil war, and unforeseen death. There's mercy that he will be kind to you, treat us as your God who loves all people. He may turn away and scatter all wrath and disease that was against us, deliver us from his impending justified chastisement, and have mercy on us. In many different formations, he's had many different visions and appearances on this earth. But every time that he's had a vision, or that he's made an appearance on this earth in some profound way, somebody has been there to witness. This is very important. It's very important that we understand that God does not do things just for the sake of, well, God, I can do it. You know, I mean, he could say, I'm the Lord, I'm just going to do it, whether anyone is there or not. No, whatever he does things, whatever they are, he does them so that we may benefit from it, and so that we may praise him in the process. We praise him not because he is God, although we should. We praise him in gratitude. We praise him in appreciation.
turn back and say, thank you, God. You know, they all praise God, but the one turned back and say, thank you to Jesus who healed me. You know, there's something to be said for that. So when God went to visit Abraham and Sarah, as is shown in this icon, the manifestation of the Trinity, it's an image, it's a type of the Trinity. This isn't necessarily the Trinity, it's just an image or a type of the Trinity. It happens to be a less controversial one than you know, the one that I spent a long time teaching us about. But when God went to visit Abraham and Sarah, they didn't just appear on this earth, they visited Abraham and Sarah. It was God visiting, God doing something for mankind, God showing himself in this powerful way. And we've all had it. Every single one of us has had a moment in time when we know God was present. Without question. You don't have to think about it. You don't have to guess, was he there, was he not there? We don't need somebody else to interpret it for us. We know in our bones, in our DNA, God is there. God was present. We know. Just like Abraham and Sarah knew they were talking to God. They didn't have to guess. They knew. So when God, it's not like if a tree falls down in the forest, it doesn't make a noise, right? But nobody's there. No, this is God. When God comes down, somebody's going to be there because God is going to ordain it that way. God does not do things in a vacuum. He doesn't do things on his own. He is going to make sure that his works are manifest on the earth, not for any other reason than because he wants us to benefit from them. He didn't make creation and then make us first and then have us watch creation. No, he made the entire gift of creation, and then he placed us there and said, look what I did for you. Look at this great gift. He wants us to participate in the joy that he has offered us. And that goes in every aspect of our life, whether we're talking about, you know, some of the tough times, some of the good times, whatever time, the time is now to praise God. Even amidst our sorrow and suffering. And we all go through times and times. Some days are better than others. The time is now to praise God. You know, that's the most important thing. So, we recognize that. We recognize it in the saints. And we have perfect examples of how the saints praise God throughout the most difficult circumstances, especially the martyrs. We have their example of how they really, really saw fit to praise God. So we have this important time in our lives where we understand that. We praise God for it, and we ask God to be present. So at this time, we are going to finish the service, and then I'm going to see where they are at the end of your page. Come forward to kiss the light.
All those who shelter over the one, those who win their faithfully unto you, with your strong hand you protect. We who sin have no one else who seeks for us. Before God, praying endlessly in ills and of dangers for us who are laden with our many sins and mistakes. Mother of our God in the highest, therefore we fall down to you humbly. From all our misfortunes, keep your servants safe.
Yeah.
prayers of all the